Okay, this is another sewing video. I know it's 2 days in a row, but I have this shirt that I made. I embroidered it myself, obviously, but it kind of looks really good, except I haven't fixed the sleeves. I want the sleeves to look like this side, but you can't keep rolled sleeves. I mean, everybody knows that rolled sleeves are impossible, so I'm going to attempt to sew them and roll them myself. At first I embroidered them on the outside and it made it look like a little stitch and it was cute, but it wasn't practical, I guess you could say. So I'm going to go get some string. All of this stuff is behind me, so I'm just going to turn around and get it. All right, so now I'm going to get started on this. I guess I could talk about yesterday. Yesterday, Jay and I went to Starbucks and we read for a while, and we learned that Albert Einstein died in 1950 something, and that just absolutely like blew the both of our minds, because I thought Albert Einstein died in like the 1600s. No, Shoddy lived through the Holocaust, and we were like, what? And then we were like, no, and then we had to like rethink our entire lives, and that's when we decided we were done reading for the day. I hadn't gotten any reading done. I'm reading the Picture of Dorian Gray, and it is a great book. It's a great book, but the problem with it is that this is a weird needle. I don't know if this is the right needle to use because it's really strange. I picked up the wrong one. This is an embroidery needle. I really like it, but the thing about it is it's very, very like detailed. Like the way Oscar Wilde writes is very, it's like, it's hard to read unless you're like extremely focused on the picture that he's trying to portray. So if you're not paying attention, then it's not any good. Like, you don't understand it. And that could just be me and my dumbassery, but that's what I've learned. And I was editing my video from yesterday that I was making, and I said like so much, and I was like, I was sitting there and I was watching it and I was going like every other word. And granted, I watched a lot of Scooby-Doo growing up, so I attribute most of it to that, but I was fully embarrassed in myself, as one should be when they talk like that. If other people talk like that, I apologize. It's just my own insecurities about the way that I talk. I was afraid my southern accent would show through like really, really badly, but it didn't, so I'm happy about that. I'm just trying to fix the like problem, really. I'm giving myself notes. I also said a lot, so also trying to fix that. But we were reading, we found that out. Jay's reading the biography about Sylvia Plath. We both really enjoy her work. Me, specifically, just The Bell Jar. I haven't read any of her poetry. I know I'm a fake fan. But, you know, if you're going to be a feminist, you have to read The Bell Jar. That's, like, the thing. like, goodness, kid. What are you doing? But, as I was saying, we found out that he was in... He died in 1950, and we were like, whoa. So we decided that it was done reading. We were done reading for the day because that was too much for our little girl brains to understand. Just a little subtle misogyny there for you. And we decided to go to the grill. And there's a grill downtown. It's called the Grill and Brewery downtown, and it's really like nice. We love going there. I had the chipotle tomato soup, and Jay had nachos, and that's not really something I don't think regular people get stuff like that at the grill. I think we're just weird. It was really good, and we enjoyed it. And then we came home, we went to Kroger's and got pumpkin spice cookies because we're basic little bitches, and we made those. We made those at like 11 o'clock at night, and my brother had school today, so we were in there like laughing and cutting up and stuff, and my dad was like, hey, your brother has school, and I was like, you right, sorry, my bad, my fault, Twitter is like blowing up my phone lately, and I think it's because I'm spending more time on it, so it's like, here's more content, so you will spend even more time on our app. I've been trying to give myself like notes about what I've been doing wrong in my videos, and one of the things I'm doing wrong is I'm not very happy looking. I feel like I'm very monotone, but Jay says in person I'm very uppity, and I don't know if it's just not showing through on camera or like what. So that's a little irky, I have to be honest. Yeah, I think it's just been a stressful week, so my energy isn't really showing through, and I've been like sleeping in late like a lot, and I'm trying to get back in the routine of like doing things with my life, you know, because I haven't been lately. I've just hit like an exponential amount of burnout to the point where I like don't want to exist if I'm not sleeping, you know. And I'll go to bed and I will wake up like 1,000 times during the night because I keep checking my phone, and I need to get off of that. That's something I need to stop doing. I worry about myself and my phone addiction. We were talking the other day about weddings, and this girl had her phone on her, and we were like, where do you put your phone when you're getting married? And I was like, well, I would have to have it on. I'm so addicted to my phone. Like, if I don't have my phone on me, I'm like anxious. Like, where is it? And my parents have been like joking and being like, we're checking your phone. No, you haven't. If you were checking my phone, I wouldn't have a phone. But that's neither here nor there. I'm glad they don't check my phone, because that would lead to quite a few conversations that we would have to have. Not that I do anything bad. I'm not. I never do anything wrong. My sister wants me to make her a poke cake before she leaves for college, so I have to go do that this afternoon. Awkward silence there. Anyways, I haven't been getting much sleep lately, so I've been waking up a lot later, which obviously that makes sense. So panic prone lately, and I don't know why. It really is just extremely irky, because, and my parents are like, what are you doing? You're not doing anything to be stressed out. And I'm like, I just have anxiety, you know? Okay, I'm not finished, but my family is coming home in like 5 seconds. So I'm going to sign, hold on, I got string. So I'm going to sign off real fast. Here it is. Here's this side that I finished. I think it looks really like good. I might crop it a little more. Yeah, I'm really excited. It looks good. It's cute. It's not as like bad as my porn star shirt, so I'm considering that a win. I can wear this around my family and them not be totally disappointed in me. So yeah, thanks for watching. Peace. Okay, so here's what it looks like. This sleeve's a little messed up. I tied it a little too tight, so it kind of goes out. I'm not sure how I feel about it. I like this side better, so I might have to fix this one, but if it's like too noticeable that the thing is I pulled it really tight so that I could tie it off, and then I was just gonna pull it back out, but then I tied the knot too far in, so I messed up. But it's okay. I think you can tell really easily, but if I iron it, maybe that'll fix it. I don't know, but here it is. Cute. I like it. I'm a big fan. Maybe I'm gonna crop it some more, because it goes down past my belly button, so that's not as slutty enough for me. All right, bye for real this time. Peace.